first questions we get a lot is, you know, what is an AVM, an arteriovenous malformation? And while there are certainly actually books written about the subject, the short answer is it's a sort of collection of abnormal blood vessels that are there from birth. They're almost never there because something happened. You didn't hit your head or eat a bad cheeseburger. Connections between high pressure arteries that come from the heart and low pressure veins that go back to the heart are connected in an abnormal way. And the reason that's bad is that typically in a healthy set of circulation, those big arteries will gradually get smaller and smaller, which reduces the pressure and slows down the flow. But in an AVM, those connections are immediate and the blood flow is very, very fast, which can stretch the veins, and that can cause three things to happen. They're bad because they can enlarge and push on the surrounding brain, which can cause the nearby brain not to work very well. They can have very high flow through there, which kind of sucks blood like a vampire, if you will, away from the adjacent brain, and the brain is kind of hungry. You get this thing called gliosis, where the brain has this steel phenomenon, and it may cause problems with how the brain functions. And the scariest one is that these AVMs can bleed. The vessels can stretch, they can pop. And the scary thing about that is if these things bleed, there's a very high chance of very significant problems or even death. So these are bad things if we see them. And most of the time when we see them, we try to have a conversation about the best way to treat them. So that leads to the next question, which is really, how do you diagnose these? How do you know they're there? And we'll try to address that in the next little video.